Are you or your partner addicted, do you think, to gaming or concerned about the amount of time you spend playing online games? If so, it could be having a bigger impact on your relationship than you realise it. And to discuss this, as ever, is our relationship expert now with me, David Kavanagh. David, you're very welcome.
Thank you.
How common a problem is this? This idea that somebody would... We discussed it in the office and one of the guys was saying that he has friends who do this. They live with their girlfriend and in bedtime comes around, they actually go to bed with their girlfriend and all that. But then as she's fallen asleep, they get back up and go downstairs and go online and start gaming away and playing whatever games they're into. Is this a very common phenomenon?
It's fairly common, I think. I mean, it's hard to get stats on these things because people are notoriously shy to admit that they have problems with things. But I think there's a certain kind of cohort or an age group of people that are certainly potentially addicted to gaming or maybe using it excessively, to put it in a different way.
Okay. I'm struck by the fact that is this a little bit like any other addiction, as in somebody's a drinker or somebody's a gambler or somebody's looking at porn or somebody's online shopping or whatever they're doing.
Sure.
That you're kind of, your partner is lost to you while they're zoning out doing this thing that they're doing to escape life. It doesn't really matter which of the things that they're doing, but they're escaping their lives in some way by doing these things.
Yeah, well, I guess the difference between gaming addiction and porn addiction is that there's no sexual nature to it. Not really, not to the same extent as watching pornography. So women whose partners are gaming addicts mightn't think that it's as big a problem, for example, as somebody's addicted to pornography, because
they mightn't be as judgy about it.
Mightn't be judgy or mightn't be as offended by it or mightn't feel that it's a slur or slant in their relationship in a negative way. So they might just be more accommodating of that fact. But then again, that also might hide a problem in the sense that the person is disconnected from them emotionally, disconnected physically because they're in a different room, or is so competitive with other people that their focus is gone completely. So if your partner, you know, if you're somebody who's upset, for example, and you've had a bad day or stressful at work, you've had a lot of stress at work, then if your partner is a gamer, then they're listening to you, but they're really just kind of thinking, okay, wait, you finished? Is this it now? Have I answered your problems for you? Meanwhile, back in the ranch, can I just go back and play Fortnite or whatever it is that I'm currently addicted to? So that can then feel very disconcerting for the person who's in a relationship with a gamer.
In my mind's eye, there's a stereotypical person doing this and they're a bloke and they're in a dark room and they're playing Fortnite or Grand Theft Auto or whatever it is that they're doing. But equally, women do this too, because I've read stuff online that some of the biggest users of games, and they're different games, so they're Tetris and Solitaire, types of things, are actually middle-aged women. They're zoning out there too. They're hitting some kind of a game for 3 and 4 hours or doing it with Facebook or something equivalent.
Absolutely. I mean, you can play Candy Crush on your smartphone for hours and end and be in the same kind of situation. So does it matter really if it's on a PC monitor or a big TV screen or it's on a smartphone? If you're gone for hours on end and you're not meeting your partner's needs, you know, fair and reasonable needs, then I think the relationship has a difficulty.
So how much is too much in terms of gaming? Is it okay to play for an hour or two a day, or is it only when, like, we did hear, we talked about cyber addictions before, and there was people texting and saying they were playing for 14 hours a day, which strikes me as awful for them.
Sure.
But is there a kind of a worrying amount of time, or is it not about time per se?
Well, there is a worrying amount of time, but for me it's about what does the partner think is okay, because somebody who has a very high tolerance of gaming might think that their partner being online for 8 hours of a Saturday is fine, because, you know, he or she is off shopping, meeting their friends, going exercising and whatever, and they have no issue with their partner spending 8 hours of a Saturday or a Sunday online. Somebody else might think 1 hour is too much. What are you doing? That's crazy. So I think that there's an individualistic piece here where the couple themselves have to decide what's reasonable and fair. But it's like how you spend your time in any relationship. How much time do you give to the person that you're with? How much time do you spend your friends, your family, your work, your career, whatever? You kind of have to have conversations about these things. And that's sometimes where people let themselves down. They don't have open and frank conversations. They just get resentful.
Yeah, somebody has texted and said, I'm really glad you're covering this. My boyfriend is constantly on his computers, and says in brackets multiple, so obviously he's a lot of computers.
Sure.
And we fight about it all the time and he doesn't want to know. I know other people who complain, for example, that their partner sits down and watches like 10 hours of golf at the weekend. Sometimes they play it too, but sometimes they actually just sit and look at it. So it strikes me that many of us in the world, in our relationships, zone out of our relationships and engage in that kind of fubbing, the phone snubbing.
Sure.
or this type of thing. I don't know. Keith says, for example, isn't marrying somebody, let's say, in their late 20s who's still playing a lot of video games a red flag to the relationship itself? But I get what Keith is saying, but don't lots of us lean on certain things to make I don't know, life a little bit easier. Yeah, as a crutch in some way.
We do, of course. And I mean, it's, again, you know, I would have played games in the past with previous partners and we would have had great fun. So there was a positive thing that I kind of, I think maybe needs to be mentioned here as well about gaming, that for some couples, it alleviates stress, it alleviates frustration. Because I used to play Mortal Kombat type games with my ex-partner and we used to just kick the head off each other. And it was great. And it was so much fun.
Is it different if you're playing games with your partner than on your own, because with your partner then it's an inclusive sort
it's
of
inclusive.
A thing?
It can be fun, it can be something that you both look forward to. I remember playing Zelda or something for hours on end back in my late, my early 20s, but it was hours spent, but we did it together as a couple, myself and my ex-partner, and it was wonderful. It was just fun, and it was better than watching television because you're engaged and you're making progress through the game.
So is that a more, because exactly, you said it was better than watching television. Yep. Lots of people will sit down and watch Netflix, three episodes of something back to back with their partner. They'll sit there, they won't be talking, they're correct, snuggled up on the couch, 3 hours of watching, you know, back to back episodes of whatever series they're into. So, you know, there are companionable things you can do, but is the difference doing it with somebody than doing it excluding somebody?
It's excluding somebody, doing it by yourself, and then it's the other people that you're possibly interacting with online, right, as well. So a lot of these games are multiplayer games.
Lastly, if somebody is worried about this in terms of their relationship, that they're doing too much of it or their partner's doing too much of it, is there any help? Is there anywhere for them to go about this sort of thing?
Well, I think you can talk to a psychotherapist about it, because I've worked with clients who are gaming addicts and worked very successfully. So talk to somebody who's a professional.
All right. Listen, thank you for that. Indeed, that is David Kavanagh there. Of course, we'll be doing relationships again next Tuesday.